Hello everyone, welcome to BIM Modeler. This is Raj. In this tutorial, we're going to watch how to create a air terminal in our project. What are the different options available to place them? And what are the types available in air terminals? How to change their heights, rotate them? So there is a connection point in air terminal. So understanding the different types in them, an instance and type property of the air terminals. First of all, what is air terminal, also called diffusers? The room keep a running total of amount of supply, return and exhaust air supplied or removed from the room. So basically it is a component in a building. You will see it in your ceilings most probably. They will be control your requirements of the rooms, such as supplying of air or removing it from the room. It may be a return or it may be an exhaust. Some of the air terminals also placed on the floor. Sometimes it depends on the requirement. Some of them may be placed on the wall. It depends on the projects and requirement. What are the types available? If you see that there are basically three types based on the air supplied or removed from the room, which is supply diffuser, return diffuser and exhaust diffusers. Based on shapes, there are things like grills and diffusers. So egg grade or bar type, transfer type, so lower bladed air, straight bladed, linear slot. In even in that we have a different diffusers, like based on the direction, we have one direction, two direction, all four sides directions, corner diffusers. So there are different types based on their functionalities and the shapes, and there are different options available. Even round and rectangle, square types are also available. So basically it supplies or extracts the air from the room. So the image that you see on the top side, it is grill. On the bottom you see that it is a ceiling diffuser. Basically, in every design drawings, we used to have a symbols for air terminals. Also, we have a symbols for an air terminal which is placed on the floor plan. Will be having the most probably these symbols. So the arrow indicates the airflow direction, and if you see supply, it goes outside. For return, it goes inside. For exhaust, also it goes inside. But if you see that the difference in the middle. So always the return air will have a symbol something like these. So square or rectangle shape with the diagonal line. If you see the exhaust, which is having an additional line, which is connecting the diagonal line in this place. For a supply, it will be cross line. So you have to remember these shapes and the arrow directions. And if you see them in 3D, all look similar. It will be based on the family created in the projects. So based on this, you have to place in your exercise file. The hands-on file will be given. You can take the whole project that we have started earlier, or I will be adding this current model file to the hands-on in our bimmodeler.com. You can download them and you can practice them. So I have a building here in this place, a small project to understand how to place them. So if I go to the 3D view, you will be able to see that it's a simple project file which is there. And if you go to the mechanical, and which is here, and ceiling plan. So there are ceilings also created, which is 600 by 600. The other one ceiling diagonally available, and which is 600 by 900 shape. So I have also placed the ductworks for our understanding in the ceiling plan. So we will be going here and we can place them in this system tab. The air terminal option is available in this place. Whenever you take a system default template from the for starting the project, if you are taking the air terminal, by default it will be in level 1, the level current level that you are in, and it will be on the 00. Most of the people, we as a person still I am also doing the same mistake, that I am placing this on 0 level. So we used to place them on 0 level. If I have an exhaust, I am looking for a supply. So I can search supply in this place. So I'm looking for a supply diffuser. If I take the supply diffuser, if you see that, I can place them wherever I need. So if I try to place them, so it will be 0, 0 height, and just click that, it will be placed. As simple it is. So if I select both of them and click the section box option, which is right in this place, BX, and you will be seeing that the current model, the last one which I placed, it will be placed on the floor, because the height elevation from the level, it is 0. So most of us used to do these mistakes. So the ceiling height will be, we have to place them at 2400. So by mistake, we used to place them here. You can use the align command like this, and you can align them, or you can simply change the elevation value like this, or you can simply select them, go to the floor plan and select them and change their elevation value as 2400. And if you see them on the 3D, now it will be placed, both of them are in the ceiling. When if you are trying to place a air terminal, there are different options available. Create similar, you can right click and say create similar, or you can press CS so that the same element will be created. There is another option, air terminal on duct. You can see them. What does that mean? So if I select these ducts, and if I go for a section box option again, in 3D, you will be able to see them, that there is an air terminal which is placed underneath this duct, or you can place them side by side in this place. So when you wanted to place an air terminal on the side of the duct, you can use these options, such as like these, or underneath, bottom like that, and it will be placed your side of the ductwork, or your any size that you wanted. So for understanding purpose, I'm showing it in 3D, but usually we used to place them on the floor plan. I'm going back to the floor plan, to the ceiling view. So by mistake, we have placed it in the another place, so we have to align them using align command in this place. We also need a return grill, so we can create air terminal by pressing AT, or you can press this command and you can go to the return grill option and you can place them in this place. So the height is 0, so it's not showing up. 2400, coming back to this place, and if you see that, it by default it assigns. So it is that you have to remember, so we have to place them in a height, so we have to change their height, and in a place that we have to place in ceiling, so that we will be able to place it in right place at the first time. Each air terminal, and depends on the requirement, they may have one or more connection points. In this connection point, we will have to connect the air terminal, air ducts. So for example, if I select the supply air terminal, it shows the cross symbol as we discussed earlier, and it shows that as their dimension and their direction of the airflow. The air goes inside the air terminal in this point. If you see the return grill, so it will be having the out direction because the air comes out of this air terminal. And going to the next option, if I see that there is an exhaust grill in this place, you can go ahead and select the exhaust grill. I can place it in this room using the height 2400. The ceiling still not placed in this floor because it will be aligned later time. Not a problem, we can place it here. We have to place a supply grills in this place, but in a direction of different one. So for example, air terminal. So instance property, if you check that, there are other than the heights we have in below, we have up arrow, right arrow, these arrows. You can turn it on up and left arrows, so that down arrow. So if I place them, so you can see that there are two arrows which is hide out. So it means it directionally applies to two directions, not on the other directions. Create similar, and the same arrows settings applies and we can place it wherever we need it. And so we can create another air terminal in these places, but the directions are different. So if you see here, if I try to create the same, I can rotate it based on the space key. You can press the space, the air terminal rotates like these. And if I want to place it in this direction, I can place it like this. Air terminal. So again, if you see that on the bottom side, you'll have some values. If you check your rooms, by default, the space element, there is a property which is called actual supply airflow. It means by default zero. If you are doing a design, so it will be very helpful. If you are selecting it, it will be zero by default. But after placing an air terminal, your space will have a property which is 1,175. The reason we have placed 5 air terminals in this room with a supply value of 235 each liters per second. The pressure drop is 14 per so PA, so it will be, so based on that it will be calculated. To place an air terminal in this room, we need a 600 by 900 diffusers, but by default we have a 600 by 600 diffuser in this place. To create a 600 by 900, if you see that edit type, the same type, and if you see that only 600 by 600 is available. I press create similar CS, and if I go nearby that and the match, it doesn't match us. Use the edit type. So it is a type property of the air terminal. And if I try to duplicate these as the required name, which is 600 by 900. And if I press OK, and if I try to change this 600 by 900 into a 900 value, automatically the other value changes. It means in the family, so they have applied a formula which is both width and height will be equal all the time. We have to edit this before placing this air terminal. So create an air terminal to edit this 200-400. So we have to place them in a direction that we needed. So before that, create it here, select the family, click edit family. The family will be loaded inside, and in this place, family type, if you see that the diffuser width and height applied with formula, remove this formula. Now we are in 600 by 600. Go to the 600 by 900, change their value as 600 by 900. 600, 900. Select OK and load this project into the project. Override the version. And if I select it, and edit type, I can change this value, select OK. Now if you see that it is 600 by 800. Use the create similar CS and take this element to the place, right place here. And by hovering the one line and press space, automatically it aligns with the line like these. After that, you will be able to place in exact position that you needed, whatever the location that you need it to be. So for example, in this place, and we can place it like this. So this is how you will be able to rotate them and place them wherever you need it. Align them as per your requirement, place that you need it. Some of the grills, it may require to place them on the wall, or some of them need to be placed on the floor. In that case, you have to have the hosted elements. So it is a host based elements. For example, these elements, whatever we have placed, it is non-host elements. We can place it on offset height based on the offset height. If I select air terminal, there are different air terminals which I have loaded earlier. So if you want a new air terminal, you can load it from here after taking the air terminal. Or under the insert tab, load family, you can use and load the families. I'm under the folder which is Autodesk Revit 2020 libraries, US metric, mechanical, MEP, airside components, air terminals. Under these, whatever the air terminals that you are looking for, you select them and load them into the project. Once it is loaded, you can select it. For example, I need to place the floor-based diffuser. Floor, if I type floor, floor mounted, supply register, 600 by 600. And you will be able to have the option to place them on the floor or ceiling that you need it. So go to the air terminal system, air terminal, floor mount. It says that place on vertical face. We don't want it to place on vertical face. We want it to place on the face, floor face. You can select them. The floor will be highlighted. You can see them. And wherever you need the corner of the room, the place that you need it, you can place them as per your requirement. Now, if you select it, and select the space or the room, create the box, you will be view it in the 3D that it is placed on the floor. Coming back to the floor plan, and you will be able to place other air terminals, which is maybe an exhaust grill, which is on the floor plan, exhaust places, or wall mounted, which we have not loaded. The grills. So these grills are single deflection, rectangle face and neck. So it depends on your requirements, you can place them. So I need a grill which is supposed to be on the wall like these. If you see that placed on the vertical face, the wall will be a vertical face. You can place them wherever you need it and align their height, the height you need it to be exactly matched with. That's it. So by using these options, you will be able to complete your project, the required shapes and sizes. Place them, load them and place them in the project and practice them. If you have any queries, leave your comment below. So we do BIM modeling services and parametric family creations. Do let us know if you have any inquiries in the comment section, or you can contact us through bimmodeler.com. Thank you so much.